salvage office. This is an exciting time, right? And you're getting letters from colleges, some good news, some bad. The thing is, you're starting to see your options and the fruits of your labor. For some of you, maybe you already know where you're gonna go. You could send in your deposit tomorrow. For others of you, maybe it's the opposite. So what do you do if you've gotten in somewhere or a couple of somewheres, but you're realizing that they're not the right somewhere? Today and over the next week, I'm gonna be addressing this question and some more of those pesky what ifs that are probably popping up. First, it's okay to be sad. You put a lot of time and energy into your applications. It feels like your whole school career up to this point is culminating in this moment. You can cry and be disappointed. But believe me, if you got rejected from Carnegie Mellon or University of Michigan, you are not alone. So take a few days to feel down, then dry your tears, dust yourself off, because your future is waiting. Okay, so what if you didn't get into any BFA programs, only BA schools? I understand that this can feel like a real blow, but I want you to remember back in the fall when you made your list, there was a reason that you put every school on it. So go back to that research and try and remember why you were so excited about the schools that did accept you. I'm sure that you'll come across some amazing program or opportunity that you were totally psyched about back then. Try to let go of the things that didn't work out and focus on what did. Now, set up some visits to the schools that you did get into. Before you go, make a list of some of the things that are important to you and some of the things that you're hoping to see. You may already have a list similar to this from when you visited schools last year. Try to put the schools that rejected you out of your mind and focus on the feeling or environment that you're hoping to find. It's important that you go into these visits with an open mind, because remember, these schools want you. They like you. You owe it to them and yourself to at least try to like them back. And lastly, please don't beat yourself up. Don't try to get inside the minds of the admissions people and figure out where it all went wrong. At the end of the day, in this application cycle, this year, you were not a good fit for the school that you thought you would be a good fit for. They already have one of you, and for whatever reason, they deem this other version of you preferable. And yes, of course it's their loss, but you can't dwell on that. There are schools that did pick you. They do want you, and you should start thinking about that. And remember, you're not committed to staying anywhere for 4 years. Transferring is always an option. And beyond the emotional stuff, there are some practical considerations to think about as well. Things like distance from home and how easy or hard it is to get there, financial aid packages, what the living situation's like, what the food is like. Now that you know what your options are, you can really start to think about the reality of the decision that you're about to make. So if you've got your own what ifs that are bugging you, you can shoot me an email anytime at larainthecollegeoffice@gmail.com. And if you need some cheering up, you should check out my silly Instagram at collegeofficelaw. I know this seems really hard right now, but focus on the positive. You got into college. You're going to college. So that's all for now. Next time, I'm going to be talking all about the waitlist. Thanks for visiting the College Office. I'll see you then.